Malfunctioning railroad gates bogged down a recent rush hour for more than an hour and a half. That story is first tonight at 6. Wisconsin Southern is investigating why an electrical malfunction caused so many problems last Friday. Good evening, everybody. I'm Susan Simon.
And I'm Eric Franke. It might have been weather or vandalism. Either way, it's leading to a continuing News 3 investigation into railroad crossings in Madison.
We have team coverage tonight. News 3's Theo Keith is live downtown with reaction from an angry Madison Police Department. But let's begin tonight with investigative reporter Adam Schrager. Adam?
Susan, Mayor Paul Soglin demanded a meeting with the head of the Wisconsin Southern Railroad after our reporting last month showed the train gates down along East Washington Avenue for more than 40 minutes back in April. That meeting is set for next week. It'll likely include a conversation about what happened on Friday night at the railroad crossing along John Nolan Drive and Broome Street. This is video from one of the city of Madison's traffic cameras. This all started just before 6 o'clock during Friday evening's rush hour. The gates were down for more than an hour and a half with no train around. The railroad blamed either weather or vandalism for the electrical malfunction and said its repair specialist was stuck in traffic himself, couldn't get to the crossing for a while. We did want to point out what happened though at 6:42. When a 72-year-old Deerfield man went around the police barricade and ended up crashing into one of the railroad gates. You'll see it right there. There he goes, crashing right into that gate. He was arrested for operating under the influence. The city of Madison has an ordinance preventing the railroad gates from being down for more than 3 minutes during rush hour. That ordinance, though, has not been enforced for more than a decade because of numerous federal courts have said that cities cannot control railroad crossings. That is the responsibility of the federal government.
All right, Adam, thanks.